They cried unto the Lord out of their taskmaster hurting them so bad. And then the Lord appeared to Moses, and Moses had to look and said, what is that? That's a bush. See, so the Lord would just throw your answer right in front of you. And sometimes we just go right by it. Your answer will appear. Moses looked over there and said, what is that? Let me get closer. What is that? Bush burn. Okay, bush is all burned up. Well, no, the bush is still burning. There's a bush that keeps burning with fire. How is this? So what is this? And he said, Moses. So here I am. Moses, what is that? So sometimes the Lord will give you your answer in some strange ways, but you don't just walk, keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes and ears open as to where is my answer. I already cried to God. He's going to provide it down the road. He's got to see what it is. So that's what he did. And he showed him a tree. There's a tree. So use this. When he had cast it into the waters was made what?
Sweet.
Your situation is bad like it is, but do I move from my house? Do I move to another neighborhood? Find another wife? It's bad. New kids? What do I do? So the Lord will give you something to make it better. It's right. Here's Moses at the Red Sea. Egyptians behind him pursuing. Red Sea's in front. Moses cries to the Lord, oh God. And God said, Moses, what? Have you come to hide? What's in your hand? Moses, what's in your hand? Give him a clue. What's in your hand? Oh, this rod. Use it. What? Stretch it toward the sea.
Stretch it toward the sea.
Now, you got, there's some things that you got. Sometimes I call it seed stuff. It means that if you take it and plant it, or utilize it, use it, it'll come out to your advantage. You ain't got much. I mean, I know you ain't fooling God. You know you ain't got nothing. I mean, you know you ain't got much. You don't try to pretend to God. You ain't got much. I just got this old broke down jar. God will say, see that old lady trying to cross the street over there, get you outside the neighborhood, outside the city? Give her a ride. Happened to me and Candy one day. Remember that? Coming out of Walmart. Just mind our own business, pushing my car. Sir, I thought she was a pan. Finally, I say, this guy to me. What? Can you give me a ride? Oh, no, which way are you going, north? That's what I'm going to say. Call us. Please say, I'm going north. Yeah, I'm going north. Can you just give me a ride? Up to 61st or something. What's that? 81st Street over 81st and Lewis walk there. Up to 61st and Yorktown. So like, Lord got me. Yeah, I can do that. I got to go that way to go north. Yeah, I can do that. So I don't know. Now, we don't know this lady. But then it came to me. You remember when you was in Korea? I said, yeah, that's what I'm driving. There was a person that approached you, and you didn't know who that person was. And to this day, you believe it was an angel. You remember that? Yeah. I said, this time I'm keeping an eye on it. This could be an angel. I'm keeping an eye on this one. That happened to me over in Korea. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So we take her home and everything, and she starts talking about the Lord. Here's an old lady. Grab a horse. Here, we take him up the stairs. We put him in. I don't know what that lady, or what this is all about, but I planted a seed. And sometimes later, down the line, this has been some month ago, maybe a month and a half ago, I can see those seeds coming up when I'm out in the marketplace. Deals that come through that I was, wow. Look at that instrument. I'm going to see it get played. What I did was helping that old
lady.
Huh? Stroud, yeah, went there to a place, and the guy said, I got finished with the negotiations, came out of there, packed up my briefcase and everything. Says, you ought to be happy. I said, yeah. He said, yeah, he just walked out here with $820. You ought to be happy.
$1,820.
So there's the Lord will put things in your way on your journey to your promised land that you, after you done cried it to him, look and see what he's showing you to use to get you across. Moses, what I got? What do you got in your hand? Moses, the rock, we'll use it.
So not only that, but that lady gave us her testimony, which was to help build our faith.
Yeah. She had a testimony of healing or something like that. So what should we drink? Well, what should we use? What should we drink? Now, verse 25. So what do we got in verse, please?
And they cried unto the Lord, and the Lord showed them a tree, which when he had cast into the water was made sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And there he made for them a statute and an ordinance. There he proved
it. So, after you get saved, all the trial is a test. It's just a test. That's all it is. What you're going through, no matter if it's a weak trial, small thing, or a major thing, is just a test. And God will show you the answer to the test if you just open up and look. Because I'm going to give you an open book test. There's the answer. You want a straight A? Look at the answer. Write them down. And sometimes we, through our pride, through our own mental mind and what have you, would not be in obedience and do what the Lord said. The simple stuff. Yeah. Hey, you know, you're a Christian. Person asks you something to do when it's in the power of your hands to do it. Do what? Do it. That's what I did. Gave away your right. My power to do it. I could have said no. That's my prerogative. I'm a free man. I could have said no. But that seed wouldn't have been planted. And every one of my lives, God has given you something that'll make the difference. It may not be like a big thing, but it'll make the difference. So he said, prove them, to test them, to see how they will respond to certain situations. Mm. All right. And said, if thou would do what? This is what God says. If thou would diligently hearken, listen to the voice of the Lord thy God, and do that which is right in his sight, and would give ear to his commandments, to his word, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases upon thee. Ooh, redemption, redemption, redemption. Which I have brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord that does what?
Diligently.
I can take this right here and give it to Sister Hill and write it down and say, I bet you if Pastor Hill see this, he'll preach it. No matter what he's got for the day, he'll preach on it. He preaches on this all the time.
Yeah.
Y'all hear as much as I do. I put none of these diseases on thee like I did to the Egyptians. Like, oh. If you would do what you're supposed to do. I can just hear him now. If he would do what we're supposed to do, he won't put none of this stuff will happen to you that's happening to the people that are unsaved if you would walk before the Lord your God like you're supposed to. It won't happen. Now, my 4-year-old grandson is now realized, he must have heard me up there at the pulpit one day, Sister Hill, because I said, I don't get sick. And then when I got him now, he's like, Granddad, I don't get sick. I don't get sick. That's what Bradley said. I don't get sick. Bradley, put your coat on so you won't catch a cold. Granddad, I don't get sick. Put your hat on. So you can't just play out there in the cold. Granddad, I don't get sick. I still have my hands. Well, put it on just to make you look good. Okay. None of these diseases are come upon you like the other people. None of these distresses. You might have to deal with them like unsaved people deal with. You don't have to be like that.
That's right.
All right, we're going to get on out of here. God bless you.
we're going to talk to people.
Oh, okay.